Administration of Ghana gets and goes about the social, economic, and cultural without fear or hindrance. The Ministry of Health takes this responsibility with the assistance of 10 agencies, and I will name only a few. You see the police here, you see the prisons here, you see the Ghana National Service here, you have the NABU, you have the National Police Council, small arms. What else we do with the arms, we do with the National Police Council, the soft and the spare, the hard work together, we promote an exceptional security architecture. The government of His Excellency Nana Akufo Addo has realized that without peace and security, there can be no sustainable development. Hence, the government has elevated national peace, security, and safety to the front burner and considered security as the single national security. That's why the government has given the Ghana Police an additional budgetary allocation of 800 million Ghana cedis to procure critical tools and equipment to ensure effective discharge of the activities. The region is awash with loose armaments following the Libya debacle and the absence of any effective national government in Libya. There are other factors. Professors are here to elucidate further on that. There are a number of extremist and terrorist groups operating in the sub-region. We have Boko Haram, we have ISIS, we have Al-Shabaab, and many more. Our northern and western neighbors have suffered extremist attacks. Our eastern border is not peaceful. All regions on the continent have their stated challenges. Ghana is the ally of peace and community, which is attracting all manner of people, the good, the bad, and the ugly. Following the directive of His Excellency Nana Addo Akufo-Addo, our borders are open 24/7 for the free flow of goods and services, as well as persons as envisaged by the ECOWAS protocol. The challenge for the Ghana Immigration Service is to keep the bad elements out and allow the good ones to come into the country. Given our porous and fragile nature of our borders, this is an uphill task which the Immigration Service is trying to maintain. The Ghana Immigration Service law, which was recently promulgated, mandates the border patrol team to bear arms. This has emboldened our officers at the borders. Government is introducing ICT complement the efforts of our security agencies to maintain peace and security in Ghana. However, allow me to stress, as the chairman noted, that security is a shared responsibility. We define security as freedom. Freedom comes with responsibility. Ghana, we intend to enjoy the freedom without appreciating the responsibility. But we are twin brothers or twin sisters. It will hold on every patriotic Ghanaian or individual or groups to ensure that Ghana remains peaceful, to attract investment for the economy to grow and expand. The government needs peace and security to create the necessary environment for the private sector to employ the teeming peace. And that is also an area that probably more knowledgeable people will have to expand upon. We shall continue to encourage the Bureau of Public Safety and other such organizations to continue to engage the ministry and its agencies as we strive to enhance public security and safety. In spite of statistics that may indicate a downward trend, the crime rate is not the best. The rate of motor accidents is nothing to be proud of. And the rate of fire incidents is one too high. We can all work together to bring these statistics to levels that we can be comfortable with and proud of. It is on this note that we commend the executives of the BPS for their report, which is being launched today. We recognize that there is a depth of research works pertaining to security matters in Ghana. It is our prayer that other NGOs would take a leaf from your work and take up research activities other equally critical areas of national Chapter 50. We shall analyze the findings and take note of the recommendations as we strategize to make our dear Ghana peaceful, secure, and safe. Thank God.
Thank you.